Alrighty, these are the seats which we have out there, all cleaned and ready to come back into this. This is the new van we got for Mandy and the kids. This is a 95 Lumina van. And I got it non-running for $240. And I rebuilt the throttle body, put new injectors in it, tuned it up. And there's a few other minor things that need to be addressed, but it's really running good now. The only downside to the van was that, well, the headliner's gone, but we can take care of that with something. But the front seats were missing. And the front seat that I'm sitting on now is from a Dodge Durango that the guy I bought the van from said, oh, here, these'll bolt right in. I just never put them in. Well, they don't match up to the holes in the tracks. So I've got one bolt and three tie straps holding this seat onto the van. And I was at the junkyard yesterday. And I've got these panels and all. Everything's in the back. I was at the junkyard yesterday. I got a factory fan and fan shroud set up, which I'll show you in a moment. I got a mirror that'll work over there. That's a power mirror. That's a manual one, but on eBay, people want over $50 for a mirror, and you know that cost me $850, so that'll work for now. There's the panels and the vent visor that started flapping off when I was on the highway yesterday. But anyhow, the air works, the heat works, everything seems to work all right, except for this power lock button. And I did pick one of those up. It's in the door over there. And we're going back today to the junkyard to get some seats. The only seats they had three of these type vans in there. Two red, which one of the seats had paint on them. Somebody had used it for work. And they had two red interiors and a silver interior, a gray interior, and an old Silhouette. And the seat back was loose on the Silhouette, and if I can find how to tighten it up, because I remember there was an issue with those, I'll get those. If not, one of the vans that had the red seats, the seats were fine, and I'll just get the red seats in and get some slip covers for them, because it's, you know, just right around here, within spitting distance from home, just not finding any of these in the junkyards. We got to get down and clean the carpet down here. Something spilled. But it's in pretty good shape, really. Pretty good shape. The odometer's jammed in the gauge cluster, so I'm going to pick up another gauge cluster today and see if I can use the parts to repair this odometer or just swap them out entirely. But it's about 32, 34 degrees out right now. It's warmed up some since early this morning. It's a cold, cold weekend we're having here in New Orleans and on the Gulf Coast. And this airbag light is staying lit. I haven't even investigated that yet. I've got a shop manual coming in the mail next week for it. And, if y'all can hear the idle there. The idle's a bit uneven. I've changed a lot of stuff. I think it may be I got a little vacuum leak somewhere. And I did replace a bunch of vacuum lines under the hood, but overall she's doing good. So yeah. So we're getting there with her. We're getting there with it. The most important thing is to get some seats in here so my wife can start driving the kids around, because we sold the Echo. The Echo is gone. So this oil change sticker up here, who knows how long ago that was, $75,691. this stopped at about 113.9. The guy I bought it from said it stopped working right after he bought it, and he drove it for 9 months. So he said, I probably got about 5,000 miles I put on this thing since I bought it. So, you know, who knows, it probably has somewhere around 120,000. It's a 3.1, no overdrive. It's got the old turbo hydromatic 125 transmission. So let's get buckled up here, and we're gonna head out to the coast. One thing that is nice about this van, is it really drives good on the highway. You can, you gotta watch your speed. I'm so used to driving the old Nissan truck and the little Corolla wagon, you know, that, you know, I feel when I'm going 70 in there, you know, and both of them, I've had them long enough. This one, you know, I looked down yesterday, I mean, the speedometer only goes to 85, but I had the speedometer buried. I'm like, whoa, doesn't feel like I'm going no more than 60, 65. She drives good. This big old windshield here. It was the original windshield. Alright, well, we'll pick this video up later when I get back home, and I'll show you the outside, and we'll see what kind of goodies I got at the junkyard. They had a few interesting cars in the junkyard. I just don't have anywhere safe to keep this camera when I'm going in there. I wouldn't mind taking a film of a couple of the cars I found in there, but we'll see what happens. I just don't have anywhere to keep the camera without it probably falling out of my pocket in this old work jacket. And I'm definitely not going to get it all scratched up in the little toolbox there. Oh, and maybe we'll have to put a radio in her. That's the radio for now. It works all right, so. All righty.
Among our community, it's wonderful to hear the choir sing his music. Again, please note the announcements in the bulletin.
I've been listening to this religious broadcast.
A little bird flies.
Out of curiosity, which Catholic church it was originated from. Sounded like a Nova Soto Catholic Mass. It's an Anglican service from Christ Church Cathedral on St. Charles Avenue in the city. Which begs the question, did the Catholic Mass mimic the Anglican service, or did the Anglican service change to mimic the Nova Soto Catholic service? Really not much difference at all. Cut it pretty fast yesterday, going back and forth to the coast, and probably doing about 80 back and forth. And even though the odometer's broken, I said I charted my route, and I got 18.2 miles a gallon. Which I don't think it's terribly bad, considering this thing doesn't have an overdrive in it. I mean, my little Nissan pickup truck, it's a 4-cylinder 5-speed, you know, I get 21 what I average in it. And, this thing actually, the cruise control works. I just had it set. It's a little too close to this guy here. But, yeah, this is the first car we've had with cruise control since we sold Mandy Saab. Lord, almost 5 years ago. This, of course, is Mandy's van. The last car that I had with a cruise control in it, I'm trying to think. I believe it was a Renault Alliance that I had back in 98, 99. It had a cruise control. that I've owned myself. In fact, you know, it's funny, this thing just happens to have crank windows and power locks, like the Echo was. I haven't owned a car with power windows since 97, when I sold my Mark V Lincoln. This is funny, it's not like I've set out to purposely buy automobiles without these features, but it's just, it's the things that I bought over the years, and et cetera, et cetera. Let's see, I'm not paying attention, I'm already going 80 here. Real easy to do this fan. But anyhow. Alright. So, we're heading back from the junkyard. We're here at the rest stop on I-10 westbound, just after you cross into out of Mississippi. And let's see what we got here. We got the gauge cluster out to 96. And, you know, the triple odometer seems to be working in that one. Oh, we got a couple of seats out of a 90 Silhouette that need to be cleaned. That's about all that they had there that was worth any kind of shot. I got a glove box for my Nissan pickup. And kind of somewhere, a little door lock actuator, broken plastic trim piece that goes on the tailgate where you lift it. It's broken, but I'm going to see if I can't do something with it because it's missing off of this one. And day's wearing on, but we'll get back home, and at least I'll start cleaning these seats up to put them in here.
See y'all later.
Take some pictures of the outside. Alright, well here it is. Give a quick walk around. With the nice wheels on it. Still got to change the mirror this weekend. Pretty good shape. I can fix that or not. The chip. Probably going to have trouble coming out in the dark here, but we got the seats cleaned up. They fit all right. And we'll take some more video working on it this weekend. In fact, I'm probably in a few weeks going to try redoing this headliner. Never done one before, but what the heck. Done everything else. Gee, these were the seats that came out of a 90 old Silhouette. And it's kind of sad. I mean, these aren't in the top shape, but these were the best out of the three in the junkyard. So those will work for now. And there we go. Spent a lot of time under that hood in the last week. Alrighty guys. We'll see you next time.